Okay, guys, welcome to our Thursday night leadership call. I'm super excited to do these calls every week. I am not in my normal surroundings today. I'm actually in Ohio, and it's funny, my friend Chris put on Facebook that this call tonight was sponsored by the Reg Pig Inn, and it's really been sponsored by that because I've had some good eatings today, and we just had a phenomenal meeting. I got to go to a BMI meeting in, I think, Lima, right, Paulette? And so you guys can see TV behind me. We just had an awesome, awesome meeting here with some new people that are just excited. And so I'm excited to do this call with you tonight. I'm going to have two people come on and share. You guys know I usually have a guest at the beginning and then somebody share some tips about how to build your business. So tonight on the call with me, and I'm kind of a quick put things together type of person. And so I can hear her laughing because she knows that that she loves dogs. I always see pictures of her on Facebook with dogs. She's a Cubs fan. Go Cubs, go! So just like my wife, you can see my wife has her Cubs shirt on tonight. I am from Ohio, and to be honest with you, I was good with whatever team won because Renee's giving me an ugly look over here. Because Cleveland lost and everybody up here are the Cleveland fans. But I've became just good friends with Sandra Kroll, and she's just an amazing person. She's fun to be around. She's helped a lot of my team members share this information. As you can see, she's a nurse practitioner over in Tampa. She's a pro five in our company. Her and Dr. Benny Maniscalco, who you see her and him on the airplane there smiling in the middle. That's just a great picture. I love Sandra's like me. She loves selfies. So, I can hear her laughing too. I love your laugh too, by the way. And so I asked her to come on earlier just to kind of share her story. I'm going to ask a couple questions and then I'm going to have a little with one of my other distributors here in a minute. So if you've just come on, just remember to mute your mic when you come on. I'm going to go down through and just make sure everybody's mics, because we have a lot of people on now, and I just want to make sure everybody's mics are muted. So I welcome my friend and nurse practitioner, Sandra Kroll. So Sandra, go ahead, have at it. Tell everybody about yourself and why you're excited about LifeVantage in the future, LifeVantage.
Well, Michael, I really appreciate you having me on your call. I was quite honored when I got your text today asking me if I would do it, because I actually had, I was featured on a call at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock. So this has been an amazing day. And I had another one at noon. And so it's been an amazing day of LifeVantage building for sure. But it's kind of interesting because when I got involved with LifeVantage, I was a little bit of a skeptic. I had never heard of the science before, never heard of the NRFG pathway. But then when I started to look at cellular biology, I realized that I had very briefly learned about it over at FIU when I was going through actually my bachelor's degree. And so I had to go back and put myself to schooling again. And after I understood the pathway and what the science was, then I started to look at all the clinical research that was out there. First, I started out specifically with Protandim, which at the time when I started this, about 2.5 years ago, there was only 9 peer-reviewed studies, and now there's 22. And so, you know, it's kind of funny how life takes you, because about probably a month ago, as many times as we've all watched that ABC video, I was sitting there during our Wednesday evening meeting, and I really listened to that ABC video. And I know that all of you can relate to what I just said, because we've heard it so many times. But really take the time to listen, because the words that were stated in that video that was recorded how long ago? Remember when John Quinones looks at Dr. Joe McCord and says, leans over that table, I wish that you could be here in my condo and I could show you, but says, well, Dr. McCord, would you suggest that I continue taking Protandim? And Dr. Joe McCord's response was so prophetic. I got chills up and down my spine as I'm watching this about a month ago. I was like, how in the world did Joe McCord have that kind of vision to the future? Because that study was not even started, that was just released about a month ago, showing that, because what does Joe McCord say? I cannot promise that it will extend your life. Are you kidding me? And study number 21 comes out about 4 or 6 weeks ago that says, what do? We increase lifespan by 7%. And so it was so prophetic. And I was like, oh, I couldn't even stand. I could hardly even sit in my chair and wait to get up there and talk to people, because I was like, are you kidding me? Did you just hear what he just said? Do you know what we have? Are you kidding me? I was like, oh my God. And to know that we have over 2,000 patients on this product and what the end results are, so everybody, instead of all their numbers and everything going south, everybody's heading in a healthy direction, it is absolutely mind-blowing to me. Mind-blowing that here I am sitting here chatting with you and being able to share exactly what's going on. So I'm like super uber excited, as you can tell. I just want to jump up and down right now.
Good, good. I'm over here with two of my good friends, two Pro Fives over here, actually in Ohio. And we're just laughing because I just had a discussion tonight about this when I said, do you remember when Joe McCord said, we can't say that we'll extend your life, and then said, guess what? Now we can say that we can extend your life. So, yeah, I mean, Sandra, that's awesome. So tell me now, just real quick, tell me now, since we've been added more icing to our cake with the Nerve-1 pathway, tell me what excites you about this new discovery of the Nerve-1 pathway. Now, especially working with a cardiologist and working with people who struggle with, you know, mitochondrial dysfunction and inflammation and more of these things. So kind of tell me what your thought process is now on that a little bit.
Well, it's kind of interesting, Michael, that you asked me that, because until this NRF1 synergizer came out, we didn't really have anything truly to treat mitochondrial disease. For a lot of people, they don't know, you guys don't know what mitochondrial disease is, but mitochondrial disease is really very disabling to patients. We do a test in the office that's called a MET test. It's M-E-T test, C-E-S-T. You can look it up on the net. Google the name, it's fine. But MET testing is a cardiopulmonary stress test that looks at endothelial dysfunction, small vessel disease. Let's make it simple, small vessel disease. But it also picks up endothelial dysfunction or mitochondrial disease. And what ends up happening is that the mitochondria cannot repair itself in an adequate fashion. And so when you don't have mitochondria that can produce the energy of your cells, then you can't function as a human being. You have profound fatigue. I mean, getting up, going to the bathroom, you're exhausted. Okay. And so it's really bad. And we right now have got a patient in the practice who was a pharmaceutical rep. She was number one in her company, and she was diagnosed with mitochondrial disease. And by the time we got a hold of her, okay, she was in a wheelchair. Okay. And she's now to the point that she's starting to walk again. And you say, well, that's, you know, I mean, that's great. But I mean, hello, don't you think that this is going to be more? No, that is amazing, because this is a very aggressive, progressive problem with patients with mitochondrial disease. You know, Dr. Maniscalco kind of jokes and kids and says, you know, I mean, we all drive a car, right? Or we ride in a bus or a taxi or Uber or whatever, right? Okay. Well, everybody who has some kind of a vehicle where they are transported from point A to point B, you take that vehicle in for maintenance, right? But the only way that we can take our mitochondria, which is the energy producer of our cells, which is basically the engine, okay, until Protandim NRF1 came about, there was no way to get your mitochondria into the shop so that they can repair themselves, so they can start doing their job again. And so it's made a world of difference in our mitochondrial patients, in the heart failure patients, and, you know, in all of those kinds of situations. It's been an amazing, amazing, you know, addition to our, you know, therapies that we offer now.
Awesome. You know, it's kind of funny. I said this tonight, and just, you know, building a relationship with so many people, I think, you know, you would agree with me that the most important thing that we do in this business is we not only get to be a part of changing history, and you work for a doctor who's been in business over 35 plus years, and it's obviously not I don't want to mislead people. It's obviously not the financial part for a doctor who's been in business for 35 years. Now, for you and I and others, we also get to benefit from the financial part. But one of the things is hopefully people can see that it's about the patients that you and Dr. Benny have. And I know Benny has said this. He said, you know, you guys are right, and you can correct me a little bit, you guys are writing less and less and less prescriptions, and mm-hmm. people off of more and more prescriptions. Talk about that maybe just a little bit, what that mindset's had to be for you, and from a medical prescription, when you're just used to writing prescriptions all the time, what your mindset had to be, kind of how that changed a little bit. Just maybe touch on that just a little bit.
Absolutely. So, you know, kind of in the beginning, when we actually initiated this therapy into the practice, I kind of was a doubting Thomas. I wasn't really sure if it was really going to work. You know, there's been a lot of natural therapy companies, supplement companies who have come in and tried to get us to implement their therapies into the practice. Some have been amazing. One was a network marketing company. Well, we've had a couple of network marketing companies who have come in. And because they did have some science, we did implement it. But I never really saw anything in the end results with these other products. And so when I heard about Protandim, I was like, okay, yeah, it's just going to be another product, and it's really not going to do anything, and we're going to waste all this time and all this energy and blah, blah, blah. But then when it actually ended up doing, okay, what it said it was going to do, not only that, but it also did actually more than what they claimed it was going to do, then I was really impressed, okay, that blood pressures were coming down, cholesterol numbers were getting better, arthritis was getting better. It got rid of my cataracts at the end of 6 months. I go to the eye doctor again tomorrow morning at 8:00, can't wait. Okay, because he's astounded that my cataracts are gone after 3 years. And, you know, and so I see those kinds of end results and being able to decrease medications. We're getting more and more patients into the practice who want Eastern medicine, not Western medicine. And so we now have a real option that we can give patients that if they don't want traditional cholesterol medicine or blood pressure medicine, things like that, I tell them, especially for blood pressure, because if it's really high, you really need blood pressure medicine until we can like ease you off of it and get you into an exercise program and weight loss and eating healthy and all that stuff. But, you know, cholesterol and, you know, stuff like that, absolutely go for it, you know. But I have been able to decrease medications for sure, titrate patients off of medicine. And been able to give them a quality of life that they didn't have before, and reassurance that they're not putting, you know, all these chemicals into their body.
Right. And you know, one of the things I really liked that you and I'll just let you answer this last bit of a question. Talk to me a little bit about how you and Dr. Benny have not only just saw this in patients, but you've actually saw drastic changes in people's blood work, like C-reactive protein. And
oh, yeah.
Talk about maybe that just last thing, just kind of touch on those things that you saw and the consistency in people's blood work of these 1,800 to 2,000 patients that you guys have had.
Oh, you're going to love it, because I've got a couple of really great patient stories that you don't even know about yet, Michael. So you're going to hear about them the first time. So it's really funny. But so I've got a couple of really astounding patient stories. Most of them to me are just kind of like average. It's like everybody's inflammatory markers go down. Cholesterol starts to drop. All that stuff starts to go in the right direction. Okay. But there was this one lady who came in and she's got fibromyalgia. And fibromyalgia is really an inflammation of a bunch of cells, usually around the joints, that really can become disabling to people. And so I told her, because she didn't want anything else, they were trying to put her on all this really expensive chemical stuff, and she didn't want to be part of it. And so what I ended up doing is I said, you know what, there's this, you know, pill called Protandim, and this is what it does, and I would suggest you start taking it, and this is the reason why. And she's like, well, is there somebody else who I can talk to about it? And I said, sure, of course. Because she more wanted to hear like a patient story. And so I got her on the phone with actually a distributor who had disabling fibromyalgia. And so after talking with her for about 5 minutes with me on the phone, okay, not about a business opportunity, it was just patient education. What ended up happening is that she started the Protandim, and her C-reactive protein, which was one of the inflammatory markers that we measure in the blood work, okay, was 60.1. Normal is less than 1.0, okay, for you guys, so you have a reference. And 8 weeks later, she came back, had repeated her blood work, and her C-reactive protein after taking one Protandim a day was down to 1.6. So you're talking about profound results in just 8 weeks, and she was able to actually go about, start cleaning the house again, and being able to pick up her child again, okay? So you're talking about life-changing situations for people. So now I had my, it's my first story. My second story, it's really funny because he comes in, it was just last week actually. He'd been on Protandim for probably about a year and a half. He was an athlete, okay? Used to play professional ball, I won't say which kind. And he came in and he was feeling the usual kind of post-pro athlete kind of joint disorders, we'll say that. And so I said, you know what, Steve, what you need to do is let's put you, I'm going to put you on this Protandim and blah, blah, blah. He's like, okay, how much is it? And he really didn't care. And so I told him, he's like, yeah, whatever, that's fine. And so he started taking the Protandim. He's been on it for about a year and a half. And for whatever reason, it's kind of interesting, I got him back last week. And he had his routine blood work like I normally do, all the inflammatory markers, the cholesterol, all that stuff. And everything started to get worse. Inflammatory markers were up, blood sugar was starting to come up, kidney function wasn't as good. And so I was like looking at him and I said, Steve, I'm like, I don't understand what's going on. You've only gained a pound in 6 months. So that's obviously not it. Are you feeling okay? And he said to me, he says, yeah, I'm feeling fine. Why? I said, well, because this doesn't make any sense. Your blood pressure up, all your inflammatory markers are up. You can compare it from this column to this column. And I said, what? I don't understand what's going on. All of this is still the same. And he laughed. And I said, what are you laughing about? And he said, well, I decided 3 months ago to stop my Protandim because I wanted to see what happens with my blood work. And I said, are you flipping kidding me? I finally got you stabilized and you decide to stop it. He said, I just became a bit of a skeptic. I didn't feel it. He said, I needed to feel it. And I said, oh, no. And I said, so what are you going to do? And he said, well, I'm going to start my Protandim again. You know. And so he went ahead and he decided to start his Protandim again. But, you know, so those. Wow. I mean, I've got story after story like that.
That's awesome. I'll have to tell you that sometime. Because I have one more person I want to share with, but I'll just share this real quick. I had the same thing with my father, and he got off of all these medications, and my stepmom calls me, and my dad's in the hospital, and so I go there, and she's like, you need to help me. He's going home today. Can you come up and help me take him home? And so I'm putting on his shoes, and now this is after 4 years on Protandim, got him off of like 11 meds, and so I'm tying his shoe and a nurse practitioner walks in and lays this bag of pharmaceuticals on my dad's lap. And I said, whose are those? And I look behind me and my stepmom is running out the door. Okay. And so I've learned a lot, Sandra. I didn't say anything. I waited till the next weekend when we went back up there, and I went and made my wife ask my stepmom and my dad while I went and played golf, what the heck was the problem? My dad decided 5 months prior to that to stop taking Protandim and not tell me, because he knows I would pay for it. I do now. And my dad is back off of all of his medications again. So we get to hear that all the time. So thanks for sharing that. I'm that's just awesome. And we're all sitting here kind of smiling at the restaurant over here. But thank you so much. Thanks for being on the call tonight.
Absolutely. Thank you.
I'll look forward to seeing you when I get back here soon to Florida. So thank you again for being on.
All right. Thank you, Matt.
You're welcome. Okay, guys, I'm going to finish this call. We got about 10 minutes. I want to bring on my friend Chris Goodrow. Chris is one of my hardworking business partners up here in Toledo. Chris is just an amazing guy. He's just a hard worker. He's been enrolling some guys now who are strangers. Actually, I can see Ken on down here. I'm super excited about Ken. Ken's going to be a rock star in this business. I've been watching his videos from up in at the New York Marathon working for ASICS. I'm excited to work with him. There's just a lot of people that we get to share business with, and guess what? We get to change lives, just like Sandra talked about. So I'm going to bring Chris on and let him just share a couple things that he's been doing to attract attention from strangers and getting people involved in this business. Cause and I know Sandra will agree with me. Let's be real. Okay. People are going to find out about this one way or the other. Why shouldn't it be from us? Why shouldn't strangers hear about us from us? As you can see, it's Sandra's mind shift from sharing something that she was really skeptical about to teaching somebody that's giving people their life back, okay? Not just changing little things in their life, drastically change. I'm sitting here with two people that you guys have heard me have on my calls before, that these products have drastically changed their whole entire family's life. Paulette just told me that her son had another cancer test here, just in completely cancer-free, has had stage 4 cancer twice, right? So I'm going to let Chris just share a little bit about some tools that he's been using to generate leads and sign people up and get people excited to change what they've been doing. So Chris, take it away, my friend.
Yeah. Thanks, Mike. I really wish I would have known earlier I was coming on, because I would have got a haircut. So I hope everything looks good. I just wanted to talk about some of the things that I have been doing on Periscope app, social media, with Facebook, and how I've been actually being able to attract people to become friends with me on Facebook, and then start the process of building that relationship, because that's the main key about this, is building that relationship. And you spoke about Ken, and I think I built a relationship about 3 to 4 months with Ken before finally, you know, we were able to bring him into the business and get him excited. And like you said, if you watch Ken on any of his social media, Facebook Lives or anything like that, he just attracts attention to him. He's that kind of guy. And I'm really sorry that this girl's popping in here. She's climbing all over me. But anyways, there's some things that I'd like to go over with you real quick is when you're getting on these social media sites, like Periscope, for instance. I had 111 live viewers the other day on Periscope. And I may have not have brought any of the people into the business, but what happened was that actually when that Periscope was over, I found out that I had 6 to 7 new people who were actually interested in following me, and they start to pop on your Periscopes more and more and more. What you're doing is you're doing like some sort of live question and answer session. So people are, they're able to engage with you. They're able to kind of have a conversation with you and speak with you. What happens then is then every now and then I kind of put a little bit of hints about the business on there. And with this lifevantage.com/start, that's really going to help people click on that link while I'm on Periscope and take them through the process and leave their emails and phone numbers. But the other day, I built this relationship with this kid because he's really big into baseball. And I don't know what you're showing me there. Oh, God, Cubs. And that's what started it. You know, the Indians and the Cubs. And this guy's actually kind of followed me, and we had this good conversation. And actually what caught this kid's attention, he's actually a college kid who's 20 years old, who doesn't want to go to college. He doesn't want to work. He doesn't want to go through the process that his dad went through, but he didn't know what the answer was to help him fix that solution. So when I told a little story about Pablo and Bruno, and if you guys have not seen the story or heard the story about Pablo and Bruno, I suggest you go to YouTube and you check it out. He actually emailed me yesterday after we had the who will win the World Series, the Indians or the Cubs. And, you know, we went into the conversation, but he says, "Hey, I really got interested in that story about Pablo and Bruno. And I don't know what this mylifevantage.com thing is about, but it looks interesting. Can you tell me more about it? And I would really like to connect with you because I want to be a Pablo. I don't want to be a Bruno." And just that little bit of a story that I shared for 5 minutes on Periscope, you know, pulled him in. Another thing that I've done is I join groups in Facebook groups, health groups. You actually have to find people who have interest in the business that you're in. And another thing I like to do also is I like to join groups of the countries that we're located in. And then I get in these groups and I find their health groups. And a lot of times people will post what kind of protein shake they're taking, or they'll post what kind of supplements they're taking. And then that gives me that open door to post that picture of Protandim. And then people start commenting like, "What is this? I've never seen it. I never heard about it." And I private message them, and it starts to bring in possible customers or people that bring them into the business. But the number one thing is that people won't join a business. They're going to join you first, and you have to find a way to get people to like you and attract them to what you are doing. One of the things that I really, really want to go over with specifically is the mistakes that people will make on social media. There are hundreds of mistakes, but there's 8 of them that I feel that I see that it's not drawing any attention or any business. And that is, if you are direct selling on your page, it's kind of a turnoff. People see that all the time, and we're taught from our leaders not to do that. Also, selling on other people's pages, you don't want to do that. That's a no-no. Inappropriate tagging. I cannot tell you how many times when we create an event, when like Mike's come into town, and people just randomly pick all of their friends and just tag them in the event, and that upsets them, because I hear people talking about that. So that's not a good thing. So don't do that. Also, inconsistent activity. One thing that Ken really, really liked about me was he was interested. I said, "Can I pull you into my team page?" We created that team page for a reason, to help people grow their business and attract more people to it. So I bring in people who are customers and people who are interested in the business that maybe the timing isn't right, and I keep them engaged. Ken saw the consistency, and he really, really liked that. He saw that I was possibly someone that he could join a business with, because I was always going to be there to help them and lead them and grow him because of what I did consistently on my page. Incomplete profiles. I'm telling you, if you find somebody on Facebook and you become friends with them, or you reach out to them, they're going to look at your profile page. They're gonna see what you're doing. So if you're posting anything negative on there, or if you're of course, every time. If you're posting anything on there that might draw people away from you, that aren't attracting you to you, that's not going to help your business. You also have to comment and engage on people's posts. If you're just being friends with them and you're not like the lady in Georgia, specifically, I comment on her stuff all the time. I really want to bring her into this business. I like her. I think she'd be phenomenal. And she has this passion for health, and her story matches mine to the T. And now she's going to be the general manager of Snap Fitness. She reaches out to me and says, "I would actually like to get your flyers and your information about your product in this gym and start sharing this with people." So, of course, I message her back and say, "We need to sit down and talk, because I want to help you. I don't want to sell you anything. I want to help you. Show you how you can grow a business for yourself and then create this retirement and not worry about living in a world of stress of money." Also, if you're not creating curiosity, you're not going to grow your business. You gotta have people wonder, like that guy on Periscope. He doesn't know anything about Pablo and Bruno. He doesn't know anything about this business. He's curious. So now we can work on him and we can get him. But those are just some of the tips that I like to do. You know, you got to approach this business in a way that you're helping people. you got to do the same thing on social media that you do out in the real world when you're talking to your friends. You just want to find ways that you can help them and grow their business, somehow pay the business forward that is going to be helpful to them, and just be genuine, you know, have that desire to succeed and want them to succeed as well. I could go on for about 2 hours, but I know we're running out of time.
Dude, we were just all sitting here just smiling and dude, I'm excited to do this. I've told you guys, Chris and I became really good friends. You know, I don't know why, but you know, we both, I know I can tell you one place where him and I will be on Saturday night when y'all will be in front of your television. We'll be in Ohio Stadium watching the Buckeyes kick the tar out of Nebraska on Saturday night. So, I want to make a little tribute to someone very special to me, as I close out this, this webinar tonight. What I'm about to do is going to, hopefully you, this is going to go to my wife. Hopefully she's still listening. So this goes out to my wife and to you too, Sandra. Those who don't know about this, this is a Cubs tribute. So this goes out to you, Chris, and this goes out to my wife. So hope you guys enjoyed tonight's call. Go Cubs, go! Cubs gonna win today. All right. So sing it, Sandra.
What do you say?
I'm singing. Yeah, there you go.
108 more years till the next one, guys. So don't worry about it. You won't be around.
Cubs are gonna win today. All right, you guys. Thank you so much for being on the call tonight. Chris, Sandra, thank you again for sharing. I love you guys. I love everybody. I'll post this to my webpage tonight. I got to let it download, and then we got to get out of here. So thank you guys for being on tonight. So God bless you all. Have a good night. All right.
Go Cubs.
Bye. Go Cubs.
That's right, Ken.
Thanks.